Universal Analytics is shutting down, but what next? Hello everyone, my name is Wesley Walker, a data analytics consultant and the founder of Walker Analytics. And in today's video, we're going to be discussing the shutdown of Universal Analytics and what next steps you should take, whether you be an agency, a corporation, or a medium-sized entity. But before we start, if any of you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more Google Analytics 4, GTM, data analytics videos in general. Drop a like down below if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, and hit that notifications bell so you don't miss a single one of our new uploads. So last week, Wednesday, Google announced that they will be sunsetting all standard Universal Analytics reports from the 1st of July 2023 next year, and the 1st of October 2023 for 360 users, so anyone who has the paid license for the Google marketing platform essentially. So this leaves people within the e-commerce space not a lot of flexibility as to when they need to implement Google Analytics 4 in order to get the year-over-year and sufficient data by the time it's sunsetting. With the deadline of July the 1st next year for all standard users, this means that in order to have year-over-year data in time for when the processing stops happening next year, you need to have GA4 implemented before then. And if you have a 360 license, you need to have it implemented before October 1st. This has naturally caused quite a stir in the e-commerce community, both the digital analytics side and other sides as well. And with good reason, this has come as a shock to some people. To myself personally, it hasn't been much of a shock. Google has been in the news quite a lot lately with issues surrounding GDPR and Google Analytics, such as Google Analytics being banned in Austria, France, and this only opens up more opportunity for Google to be banned in other countries across the EU and potentially across the world even. So Google had to make a fast decision. Bearing that in mind, what are the options that you have now that Universal Analytics will officially be disappearing next year and GA4 will be replacing it? Well, your first option is to, of course, implement GA4. So you'll have to implement it preferably before July or October if you're a 360 user in order to get a sufficient amount of data. And this, I imagine, will be the most common approach that will be taken by people in the e-commerce space. Even though GA4 is quite different to Universal Analytics in both its way of handling and processing data and also presenting information, Google Analytics, I imagine, will always be the primary source of web analytics data. So I don't imagine that changing anytime soon. But the sooner that you implement GA4 and make the transition over, the more data that you're going to have. So that's pretty much a no-brainer. The other option too is to shop around for other web analytics tools. So this is something that I've heard more and more frequently in the run-up to Google's announcement last week, and I think it's absolutely right. I think now is the time to shop around and look for maybe other analytics tools that might better suit your business needs. With GA4, the rollover happening next year, and you're not being able to roll over any of your Universal Analytics data into GA4, this means you're starting from scratch, which is why there's the emphasis to implement GA4 as soon as possible, and definitely before July this year, so you have year-over-year data next year. However, you're in the same boat if you onboard a new analytics tool. So if you want to board a tool like Adobe Analytics or any other web analytics tool that is, you know, pretty good and pretty useful and provides essentially the same thing as GA, you're near enough in the same boat. So I think now is definitely a good time to shop around. I mentioned Adobe Analytics because that is a analytics tool that I've used quite a lot in the past, and I can vouch for that tool. You can do some really good visualizations and the data analysis in there. It has its similarities to GA, but also a lot of differences. The implementation is a little bit more technical and requires a lot of more development to the data layer, but it is a very good alternative to Google Analytics, and especially Google Analytics 4, which, if we're all honest, is still in its infancy and still has quite a ways to go before I would say it is in a position where it can fully replace Universal Analytics. And the advantage of going to a tool like Adobe Analytics or a different tool versus GA4 is that Adobe Analytics is in a place where it's very established. It's a tool that's been around for a long time, and because it's established, you won't be waiting for the tool to be improved to get to a good standard like you will have to with GA4, because there are still quite a few things that need to be delivered for it to be on the same level as Universal Analytics. With Adobe Analytics and potentially other tools out there, you don't have to worry about that problem. So I definitely think you should consider that. So in summary, Universal Analytics is shutting down on the 1st of July next year, and 1st of October next year if you have a 360 license. So your options are to get GA4 implemented as soon as possible, ideally before July or October if you're 360, or you can shop around and purchase a new web analytics tool. My recommendation will vary depending on what circumstance you are in. So if you're a corporate client who has a decent budget for web analytics, then you might want to consider purchasing a tool like Adobe Analytics, because you'll be bringing on board a tool that is already in a more refined and in a better position than GA4 currently is. And because you don't have a lot of time to implement GA4, you really need to be doing it by July. You'll be better off at this moment in time implementing a tool like Adobe Analytics, which is already established, already has a good setup, already gives you all the information that you need, rather than GA4 getting most of the information you need and waiting for the rest to be delivered to the platform. So that would be my recommendation if you're a large corporate company. If you're a small scale consultant or agency, then you probably are better off using GA4, because you can make use of the free account, which you don't get with tools like Adobe Analytics, for example. So that would probably be a better solution for you. So let me know your thoughts on Universal Analytics sunsetting next year and your options, and whether you think you will be migrating over to a different web analytics tool or implementing GA4. Let me know in the comment section down below. And I'll see you on my next video.